In the vast expanse of the world, ocean silting into fields, fields flooding into oceans over and over. Except for he who holds sovereignty over everything among all things, no one is able to lead and guide this human race.
There is no mighty one to labor or make preparations for this human race. Still less is there anyone who can lead this human race toward the destination of light and liberate it from earthly injustices. God laments the future of mankind. He grieves at the fall of mankind. Marching step by step toward decay and the path of no return. No one has ever given thought to which direction such a mankind that has broken the heart of God and renounced him to seek the evil one might be.
It's precisely for this reason why no one senses the wrath of God, why no one seeks a way to please God, or tries to draw closer to God, and what is more, why no one seeks to comprehend God's grief and pain. Even after hearing the voice of God,
man continues on his own path, persists in straying from God,
evading God's grace and care, and shunning his truth, preferring to sell himself to Satan, the enemy of God.
And who has given any thought? Should man persist in his obduracy to how God will act toward this humanity has dismissed him without a backward glance? No one knows that the reason for God's repeated reminder and exhortations
is because he has prepared in his hands a calamity like never before,
one that will be unbearable to the flesh and soul of man. This calamity is not merely a punishment of the flesh, but also of the soul.
This calamity is not merely
a punishment of the flesh, but also of the soul. Exhortations are not repaid. What kind of rage will he unleash? What kind of rage will he unleash?
It will be like nothing that has ever been experienced. Oh no.
To save mankind only this once. This is the first time and it's also the last. Therefore no one can comprehend the painstaking intentions and fervent anticipation with which God saves mankind this time. No one can comprehend and fervent anticipation
with which God saves.